Let's bring our good friend, Dr. Joe Congini, Akron Children's Hospital, to the show. And Joe, a lot has been debated in the NBA with Giannis, whether he should have been on the court or not. And, you know, that's where your job becomes sticky. And I know you're doing it with young athletes each and every week.
Each and every day, Ray. I mean, there's an office full of people waiting today to see all of us, my partners and I. And really, I joke with kids, but the very first question, what's in their head when they come in to see us is, can I play? Is this injury going to allow me to play again? Can I safely play? Or when can I play again? That's what they want to know about injuries. Yeah, you have the, you know, somebody was making that decision last night for Giannis, the Greek freak, and somebody's making that decision up in Cleveland for Jose Ramirez. You know, and there's millions of dollars on the line when it comes to those type of situations. But being in what we love the most, pediatric sports medicine, we have high school kids and we have younger athletes coming in with injuries. And I know it's on their mind. And you look at the parents and it's what's on their parents' mind. When is my kid going to be able to play again safely? And then when you see us and we're covering games and sideline coverage and stuff, it's on the mind of coaches. Coaches come up and say, when will I be able to use this kid again? When will they be able to play? And a lot of things go into it. You know, I mean, one of the things I think that my partners and I really love about being out of the office and sideline care, you don't have all these tests to rely on. Most of the time it's a new injury, so you're assessing it right there. And really all you have to go by is your examination. So the examination is the starting point always. And we're looking at the joint. We are seeing, do they have range of motion? Do they have swelling? Do they have pain? Do they have strength? What's their strength level at? And then we do a thing called function testing. That's really important. We do it on the sidelines, but we do it in the office a lot. We have a big area in our office where we get kids to run and cut and do things they'd have to do for their sport or throw against a backstop that we have in our office if it's a shoulder injury or an ankle injury, different tests that we do called functional progression to see if they're ready. And if kids have loss of range of motion or swollen joint, they're not going to be ready to play. If their strength is down a little bit, sometimes we allow kids to play. If we had waited for all of these extremity injuries till they were 100% no problems, 100% strength, we'd be waiting a long time. People wouldn't be coming in to see us because some people can play when they're less than 100% strength-wise. But then there's other things we just can't compromise on. Now, other things that help us is, like, if the kid's been practicing, this injury's been around a while, their trainer watches them. And so their athletic trainer, we often will have to call them and say, hey, what do they look like when they're out on the field? And other members of our team, if they're doing physical therapy to get their strength or motion back, we may need to call the therapist and say, hey, how did this young athlete look when she was in your office? You know, what do you think? Are you making progress with her? Is her swelling going down? Is her function improving? And then, of course, interpreting the imaging tests. A lot of kids will have x-rays. Some kids will have advanced tests like MRIs. What role does it play? That doesn't answer all of the question. Every little part that I talked about there has a part to do with it. What did the people on our team see? What do we see when we put them through functional testing? What did the imaging test come up with? And then we have to make an accurate diagnosis. We make an accurate diagnosis. We know what period of time that people are out for. We know what injuries people can play with. And that's what we do. And it's kind of fun. And this is the time of year our office is full of people, really year round, asking us that question. Can I play now safely? Or when will I be able to play? When will this injury allow me to play? Some of them even have to go next door to our surgeons, and we have to tell them, okay, for this surgery, it's going to be 6 weeks. For this surgery, it's going to be 6 months. So there's a lot that goes into that question of return to play, but that's a big part of what we do in the field of sports medicine.
And that's why, Joe, at the end of those reports, it always says 4 to 6 weeks or 6 to 8 weeks, kind of open-ended, because it's case-to-case and the recovery time by these individuals.
The recovery time can be individualized, and depending on how hard somebody's working on their rehab, and people rehab differently, and there's a lot of individual nature to it. But of course, it isn't just good for us to say, I don't know, sometime in the future. Not fair to coaches and athletes to say that. So they want a better diagnosis. So our experience of being through certain injuries and being, again, like I said before, accurate with our diagnosis, so we can give them a pretty good idea when they can expect to be back on the field again.
All right, Joe, great information, education for us on what you guys do on a daily basis. Thanks, Dr. Joe. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Ray. Have a great week.
You too. Dr. Joe Congini, Akron Children's Hospital, joins us live Wednesdays here on the Ray Horner Morning Show.